Bonjour! In this video, I want to share the process of this illustration of Magic Kitty and talk a little bit about the project, the story behind it, and some doubts I have because I have plenty. So let's talk inking supplies first. I am inking with a small natural hair brush and carbon ink. It is a very nice, smooth and waterproof Japanese ink, and I am very wary of the day it runs out because it was very expensive in my memory. If I find it again on Amazon, I'll put the link in the description below for you to find it and see for yourself. For the paper, it is Canson Montval 300 grams and it is quite a nice paper. I think I talked about it in the previous video. It has very grown onto me and I really like to use it lately for a lot of my illustration. I like it because when I ink, the texture is not too pronounced and it does very nice smooth inking. On a side note, since I filmed this video, I changed my inking paintbrush. I will talk about it next time. I will show you how the new paintbrush looks. I have a recurring problem with this one, which is the point doesn't stay fine. I've tried a lot of things that I will explain also in another video because I have other things to talk about in this one. But yeah, I have new brushes that are way better than this one and I managed to do so much finer details with the new brush, but okay. For today, I'll be painting Fluffy selling his magical goods under the coat. So Fluffy is one of the characters for the Magic Kitty fanzine that I am doing right now. In case you've missed it, I highly advise you to go see my Instagram. There is all the illustrations so far and there is starting to be quite a few. So let's talk about the project a little. So Magic Kitty is the name of the project and it is also the name of Kitty's shop. Kitty is the black cat you see in some of the illustrations. She sells her potion in a shop that was inherited from her grandfather. So we are in a magical world that is mildly medieval, middle ages, if anything can be mildly medieval, and and the Magic Kitty fanzine will be about that, about these cat witches and wizards going on their daily life. And I'm very sorry about the noise. I'm thinking maybe you're getting some of the road noise behind me, but I can't do anything about it. It's like the worst hour to record. So yes, the fanzine will be about these cat witches and wizards, Kitty, Fluffy and Bunny that I haven't talked about much. So Kitty is a potion seller. Fluffy specialty is looking for magical items here and there in the world. And Bunny, the third cat, is a crafting magical wearable like hats and gloves and magic coats and stuff like that. It's her specialty, but I haven't shown much of her, I think, so far. There is some illustration with her, but I think it's the one that has the less illustrations. I really love this universe. I've been missing adding a bit of magic and fantasy to my illustration for a while. I feel like I've been doing a lot of everyday people, like normal people, like that could be in our universe, in our world. I just wanted a little break from it. And this is where my doubts come from. You see, a while ago I talked about another project called Garden Fox. I will find the video where I talked about it and link it up there. I feel like maybe you, the watcher or follower, may be thrown off because I'm changing so fast of project and even of style. If you look at my illustration from Garden Folk, it's really not the same at all as Magic Kitty. It's humans in a more realistic style with a lot of bright colors and much more details. Here we have fantasy cats with a heavy line work and a lot of stylization in the drawing, a lot more simpler, and there is magic too. Honestly, I don't plan on giving up on Garden Folk. I love the project and it is a step forward for other projects in the same universe that I have in mind. But I also love doing smaller projects like Magic Kitty. What do you think, honestly? Are you lost? Are you lost by me doing so many different projects? Do you think I should focus on only one project and stick to it? because honestly I only talk about these two projects right now, but I also have my comic Radiance that I started publishing again on Webtoon recently. I will also put a link to that in the description if you want to check it out. And the style for my comic is also very different than these two. It is a digital style. I do everything on the computer, and also the comics is of a more sci-fi style. So, are you lost yet? Personally, I'm not lost, but you might be and I would understand. So please leave me a comment to tell me what's on your mind. Should I stick to only one project, or are you on with my multiple project journey? I've been really thinking a lot about this and the direction I want to take in my art and my projects recently, and I know I want to do little and big projects with different style and universe and characters because I love the change. I also think about my audience, you dears. You like to recognize me for one style and one project, and I'm not so popular that I can just say, hey, let's change right now. I know that to grow an audience you need to have one style that can be easily recognizable, but I'm having a hard time sticking to a style. Honestly, and as I said, I want to do small and big projects, and it's really a problem because I know that once Magic Kitty will be printed as a fanzine, as I'm planning to do, a little booklet that I will be printing and selling and everything, I'll be done with the project and might give up on the characters. Right now I'm thinking maybe not, because honestly I've grown really attached to the character a little bit more every day, creating each illustration made me create new stories and new backstories for them. But for now I have only plans for the fanzine, for this character, and I have one thing, but it's not there yet. But I don't plan on doing anything else than the fanzine for these characters. So yeah, comments please. And tell me if you're okay me doing various styles, various projects, and taking you, of course, with me through every project and every style and every illustration. Well, let's go back to the painting a bit because I rambled a lot here. So the paint I am using here is my own, as I told in the previous video, I think. This project was just the perfect opportunity for a limited palette, so it's what I am using here. It's exactly the same painting I showed in my previous video, it's just that I'm using it a little bit differently, but it's the same limited palette. In this painting, what I really love, it's the little lit window at the back. It's really a detail I like. I'm super happy about how it turned out, and you can really feel the mood. Fluffy in the back alley selling his unicorn hair to you passing by. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you'd like to support me, I have a Patreon where I share sketchbook scan and my comic Radiant early. I try to post video early as well, but it rarely happens, honestly, but I share my videos as well. But you know, the best support is likes, sharing this video to your friends and commenting. I love to answer to your comments and especially love to read them. Thank you so much for watching. Of course, see you soon for more Magic Kitty adventures.
However, because of